We are now going to look in a little more detail at the values portion where the data is generally kept. Just a couple of useful bits of information up front. As you can see, we've pulled through the bill column and you'll see it's told us sum of bill. If you want, you can pull the bill column through many times. You'll see I'll grab it once, grab it twice. As you can see, the exact same information comes through, and we'll show you later why this is useful. Also note that the column labels now has something called values. If you watch what happens here on the screen, if I grab that and drag it and put it underneath the month and let go, notice that the value headers now follow after the month. If I don't like that, grab it, move it above the month, let go. Now the value headers sit here with a month underlying it. I'm just going to put it back there. Now let's see what else we can do with the values portion. If you click on one of the numbers and you right click, you'll see you get a number of options, but at the bottom here there's something called value field settings. If I click on it, I get the following options. Just working through it, you'll see at the top here you've got custom name. So if you don't like the name that Excel has given it, you can type your own name in. You'll also notice that at the bottom here is something called number formats. Now let's just cancel out of here. If you look at this data, you may be tempted to format the data here in the normal way. Perhaps right click, format cells, and then go do some formatting. You need to realize that pivot tables stand on their own. So if you try and format the cells straight into the spreadsheet, next time you update, that formatting may be lost. As a result, the only way to format it properly is to go to value field settings, click on number format, and you'll see the exact same dialog box appears. But now when you choose the settings, just move out the way here, you can see I've only highlighted one cell. I click OK, click OK, and you'll see that entire value column gets formatted because the pivot table knows that you want all those items to be formatted exactly the same. Let's just click on this one here. I'm now going to go back into our value field settings. And let's look now at the summarize value field bar. You'll see when we drag the value field into the values item, it immediately assumes that you want to sum the information in that column. However, there are a number of other options. So for example, you could count the number of items. So if I click count and I say OK, you'll see it tells me how many items it found. So for example, there were 58 items which added up to the 184 rand. If I right click again, value field settings, perhaps I want to look at the average. When I say OK, you can see what it's telling me is on average for the 58 items previously identified at 184, the average was 3.17, for example. Let's just keep looking at what the other options are. There's a max, so it brings through the maximum numbered fines in those areas. We go back here, there's a minimum, shows the minimum number. And you'll see there are other options. There's a product, it counts how many numbers it found, standard deviation, and a few other statistical terms. Just going back here, and let's put it back to sum. Now let's look at the show values as tab. When I click on that, you'll see it says show values as. Currently it's at normal, so what it's doing is just showing the normal values. If I click on this, a whole bunch of options appear. You'll see there's a difference from, percentage of, running total in, and a number of other options. So let's just look at these. Let's go to the first one, difference from. When you activate this option, you'll see it asks you what the base field is and what the base item is. Now, what does that mean? When we look at this table, you'll see we've got January, February, March. I want to see the difference from, in this case, the previous month. So over here, I want to see what the difference is between those two, and over here, the difference between those two. In order to activate that, I have to tell it what the base field is. And you can see that by, I can see that I'm using month. So I'm going to say, please go and use the month. And then you'll see the item. I can either say, look at the previous item, so February or look at January, or next. So for example, January will look at February, or I can specify a particular month. So if I say January, not only will this one show the difference from January, but March will also show the difference from January. So I'm going to say go to previous. When I say OK, you'll see what you've got now is a difference from the previous month. So this number is 953 more than January, and this number is 222 less. Let's continue to explore these options. So I right click, value field settings, show value as. Currently we are on difference from. Let's go to the next one, which is percentage of. When I click on it, again you've got the option of what is the base field. The base field needs to be in your pivot table, otherwise it'll give you an error message, so we leave it on month. And in this case, let's rather use our base item as February. So it seems February is the highest number, so we're now going to compare everything to February. When I say OK, you'll see it gives me a percentage of February's total. So that number is 16% of February. This February is 100% of February, and that is 80% of February. Going back here, let's go to value field settings, show value as. You'll see now the next item is percentage different from, which is pretty much similar to the difference from. It just gives you, and the percentage of, it just puts the difference from in percentage terms. So we'll ignore that one for now. There's another item here called running total in. When I click on it, you'll see all it wants to know is where must it run the total from, which means that we want to have a running total in this column. So January will be 184, February will add these two together, and March will add all three together. So it can be a year to date type situation. When I say OK, you'll see what it's done is January is the starting point, February adds the two numbers together, March adds all three numbers together, and you don't have a grand total because this is a running total, and there is the total for those three items. Let's look at some of the other options. So we are currently in running total in. You'll see over here we've got a percentage of row, percentage of column, or percentage of total. Just moving this down. At the moment, you'll see percentage of row would give me what percent this makes of the row, but we don't have a subtotal here. We have got percentage of column, so we want to know what percent does that number make up of this entire column, basically of the total. So if I go to percentage of column and I say OK, you'll see it will always add up to 100%. The first item is 8% of the total, the second one is 50%, etc. That's similar to this item here, percentage of total. If you have multiple rows and columns, what the percentage will be, it'll be a percentage of the grand total of all rows and columns. And the last item is index, which helps you to calculate the relative value of a cell and can be useful. It is best to look at the help file to understand how it does that calculation. The last thing to understand about the value section is, let's say we look at this number here and we see that it's 915.52. Now it's very difficult to understand what that number is made up of, And if we had to come here, we'd have to look through the entire database to figure it out. What you can do as well is if I simply double click any particular cell, so I'm going to double click this one, what you'll see is that it's opened another sheet and it's extracted all the items from the database that make up that number. So if we had to come to the bill and we add it up, you'll see it comes to the 915. We can now look at this and understand what makes up that particular component. So again, just to show you, choose the cell you want to work with, double click it, and the information will be extracted for you.